am going to teach you about Talcott Parsons perspective on Silk Road. So Talcott Parsons is a very Hello friends, my name is Dr. Uma Hassan and today I'm going to educate all of you on a very sensitive topic, that is paid menstrual leave. Now, UPSC aspirants can expect this question in their GS1 paper, and aspirants with physiology and anthropology optional too can expect this question. Now, after identifying probable question, I believe aspirants should make some significant pointers. Now, while framing those pointers, we need to keep this in mind that we are articulating a very controversial and substantial debate. Now, how we can write a beautiful answer in it? So, we need to bring some significant theories in it, if we can. So, today in this class, I'm going to teach you that how to write an answer in such a controversial debate, which will actually show you that how you can also use some thinker's perspective on it. Because when you are articulating your opinion on these types of questions, right? Because menstruation debate, paid leave, is a very controversial topic. So how you have to put your opinion in it? How you will take your stand on it? So today in this class, you will learn this. So let's start. So this is your menstruation debate. Okay. So the debate around menstruation leave revolves that whether women should be given specific leave for menstrual pain and related symptoms. So proponent argues it acknowledges a legitimate health issue. This is a very important point. While opponents worry it could reinforce gender stereotypes and discrimination. Okay, so this is a major debate. Now, how we are going to bring our opinion on the basis of facts? Because when we are bringing some theories and when we are using thinker's perspective in it, we are giving correct information. And also in such type of question, we really have to be emotionally intelligent. Because it is related with gender issues, so we might have a lot of empathy and sympathy for this particular point in order to show ourselves that we are very gender sensitive. We can put our points. Okay, maybe those points are irrelevant. So we have to be very careful. Okay, so let's discuss that how we need to bring this point. To explain you that how we can fetch more and more marks, where we are not going to be in any impression that okay, we have written some answer which may be wrong. Okay, because we are sure that we have applied thinker's perspective on it. Okay, so today I'm going to teach you about Talcott Parsons perspective on Silk Road. So Talcott Parsons is a very renowned sociologist, okay, and he has spoke on Silk Road. So to understand this, first of all, I'll have to brief you a little bit on Talcott Parsons. So Talcott Parsons is an American sociologist. We all can remember this. So you all have to remember only one point, that okay, Talcott Parsons is an American sociologist who was writing in a modern period. In a modern period where male and female both were writing. Because when we are articulating our points, we also have to show that we are bringing appropriate points. Okay, so now what is Talcott Parsons' opinion on Silk Road? So let's have a discussion again on this. have to remember this point. Those who are coming from sociology and anthropology must be knowing this point. So, one point, those who have never heard the name of Talcott Parsons, so I'm telling you, you need to have lot many thinkers and try to apply their perspective on current affair topics. Because this is a current affair topic. You know, Talcott Parsons did not directly reflected on menstruation cycle. He spoke on illness, okay? But we are going to use his perspective for our answer. Okay, for our answer. So now, this is what we will say. Talcott Parsons' concept of the sick role is fundamental framework in medical sociology that outlines the social expectation and responsibility. Okay, so those who are writing, if you get a question in GH1, you can only talk about sick role and just relate with expectation and responsibility. Okay, so sick role has four key aspects. When we get sick, we have four key important aspects. What is that? Exemption from normal social roles. Okay, so this is what we have to understand. Let me see my teaching board. Okay, I cannot see my teaching board here. So I'll explain somewhere here. So what do you understand by exemption from normal social roles? Normal social roles mean that when we are living in a society, we are expected certain types of roles. If I am a mother, definitely as a role of mother, I have to look after my children and I have to look after my work. If I am a working mother, so I have to understand that okay, I have a role where I am working and getting paid for it. Okay, so different roles, multiple roles, and this concept is again given to us by Robert Merton. So we act in a society as per different roles. Now, when we are sick, what is happening? We are exempted from normal social roles. Okay, so later on you will see that how I am going to correlate with menstruation leave cup debate. So Talcott Parsons is saying कि आप बीमार हैं तो अब आप अपनी normal activities नहीं कर सकते, okay? So the sick individual is exempted from their usual responsibilities, allowing them time to recover. Okay? Second important point, not responsible for condition. So if you get sick, that means you are not responsible for it. Okay, that is the important point here. So we are recognizing that being sick is not a choice. Now understand. So we do have two important points, rights and we also have responsibility. Okay, so if we are sick, so it is a fundamental right. Okay, so it is a fundamental right. It is of no choice. I get sick, I have no choice. It's my right. You please acknowledge me that I am sick. But society also has responsibility. So there is another part of it. Okay, so it is like fundamental rights and it is also like fundamental duties. So citizens have some fundamental rights and citizens have fundamental duties. Okay, so we are examining in this perspective only, right? Now the second point here is, it is more of like duties, obligation to get well. Okay, so this is what you have to understand, that obligation to get well. So there is an expectation, aapse bhi kuch expectation hai, wo kya? That the individual will want to get better and return to their normal role. So you cannot always say that I am sick, I cannot work, and you cannot remain sick all your life. Okay, so that is the third point. So we society has expectations. Now, obligation to seek help एंड कोऑपरेट. तो अगर आप बीमार हैं तो आप अपना इलाज कराएं. सो द इंडिविजुअल मस्ट सीक एप्रोप्रिएट मेडिकल हेल्प एंड कंप्लाई विद प्रिस्क्राइब्ड ट्रीटमेंट्स. ओके, सो दीज आर फंडामेंटल key aspects of sick role given to us by Calcutt Parson. Now let's see how we are going to apply these four fundamental points in analyzing menstruation paid leave. Now we have two aspects on this. Exemption from normal social roles. Okay, so exemption from normal social roles. Now, providing menstruation leave can be seen as an acknowledgement of the physiological challenges women face. You know, being woman, I know that sometimes menstruation pain is very debilitating in nature. Okay, sometimes it is really very difficult for you to continue your normal role. Okay, now when we are granted with some sort of exemption, so granting them the necessary exemption to recover, what it will bring? It will bring and it will maintain productivity in the long term. So this is a positive aspect. Now what is a criticism toward this point? Menstruation is a natural. Menstruation is a natural process, right? Recurring process. So natural hai, recurring process hai, rather than an illness. It is not an illness. It is a natural process. Calcutt Parson is talking about health and illness. So when you get health, then how society should behave? And what is an expectation? But here is a catch, that menstruation is not an illness. So this is a crucial point which you people have to highlight while framing your opinion. So as we know that it is a natural reoccurring process rather than an illness, exempting women from work could perpetuate the notion that menstruation is an abnormal condition, potentially leading to lot of stigmas in society. So personally, my company have also provided us menstruation paid leave. So I'm giving you my own experience on it. So although I am also having a major issue called PMDD, that mood syndrome, and it is a medical condition in my case, used to be actually 2-3 years back. But when my company previously, I think last year, have given me this point, earlier I used to fight with it because it was not in my head that, you know, menstruation is like an illness and I should take a leave. I realized that when I have got these leaves, okay, I started taking leave for it. So I think once or twice I have also taken for this particular leave. Realizing myself that it is somewhere giving me this particular point that okay, this paid leave is there, even though I was okay, you know, in some months I was very much functional. But because I have this you can say advantage or this exemption, sometimes I thought to take this type of thing. This is actually very honest point I'm telling you. Moreover, I realized that it is creating an obstacle for my growth. Because as M.I. Durkheim says that in a modern world, when you are working, you need to be highly competitive and you also have to be functional. Because if it is not you, then it would be someone else at your work, right? And living in urban area and working, it's not really easy. So you have to be on your toes, right? And this is what I have learned when I have chosen my career to teach to UPSC aspirants. So I realized when I have taken this responsibility to teach UPSC aspirants, then I cannot take a leave on it. Okay, so this is my personal experience. So sometimes definitely I had issue, and sometimes definitely there was no pain, there was nothing in my case, and I was thinking to take a leave. But somehow I have never used this leave in a wrong manner. But let me tell you that I had this opportunity where I could use such leaves in a wrong appropriate manner. Right, so this is the debate which you have to bring. Now let's see and apply another very important point which talented person has given to us. That is when, as talented person says, that if you are sick, it is not your, you are not responsible for that condition. Okay, so we can say this, that when we are recognizing menstruation related issues, so we know that it is a legitimate health concern aligned with Parson's idea. We know that what is that? Individuals are not responsible for their illness, thereby reducing pain and promoting understanding. So this is a positive aspect. Now criticism. Now when you are framing menstruation in the context of illness, it may reinforce outdated stereotypes about women's bodies. Okay, being inherently problematic or weak, or as I have said, sometimes I started feeling weak, and although I was very much functional, okay, which could fuel workplace discrimination. Okay, so let's see an important point. Now we have obligation to get well. So definitely menstruation leave can emphasize the importance of self-care and seeking medical help if needed, encouraging women to manage their health proactively. Right? We know that because of menstruation problems, menstruation issues, we do have a lot of females who are suffering because they are not simply aware of it. Okay, so if we are giving leads to this, we are bringing gender sensitization. So generally females, and particularly in rural areas in India, females are ignorant towards their health concern. So definitely it will help in a positive manner. Now the criticism, since menstruation is a natural cycle rather than illness that can be cured, the obligation to get well does not entirely fit. So it is not an illness, okay? So the cyclic nature of menstruation makes this aspect of the sick road less applicable. Okay, so this is another important point. Now, fourth point, obligation to seek help and support. So encouraging women to seek medical advice for severe menstrual symptoms can lead to better health outcomes and reduce long-term absenteeism. Now criticism is, there is a risk that this expectation could pressure women into treating a natural process, possibly leading to unnecessary treatment or intervention. Okay, so this is what we will see. Now let's have a broader implication and societal impact on that. Okay, so now what I have done, I have applied talented person sick road theory, that how if we are giving menstruation leave, what will happen and what is its application. Now we also have to bring societal aspects on it. Now definitely it is bringing gender equality, so let's just see on this one. So menstruation leave could promote gender equality, right? Now the criticism is, it could reinforce gender inequality by creating a perceived difference in capability between men and women, potentially affecting hiring and promotion decisions. This is very crucial. Crucial, that is very important. Okay, so if we know that if government is going to make it a law that now we have to provide paid menstrual leave, now what system will do, what capitalists will do, or countries, definitely they will stop hiring women. As it is, we know that there is a gender, there is a lot of gender disparity. I know, it happens. a male walk 7 days, it is a huge respect, you know. It's a matter of huge respect, you know, that person is working for 7 days. If a woman is working on 7 days, it is not that respectable at workplace. I personally know this. Yeah, I have experienced it. It is that. It, not to say that no, it doesn't happen. Okay? And you can see this. So the kind of you know, bargaining males do. I have seen this, again I'm telling you. So the, you know, any people, if you work in any company, so in the matter of few weeks, if they are promoting and giving out output to the company. So if they are working or acha kaam kar rahe hote, within a year or within some time, they start negotiating. So they start negotiating with company holder. Ki aap humko itna pay kar rahe hain, hum ye kaam kar rahe hain, hum wo kaam kar rahe hain. But I think more or less, I can say this in the case of females do not do that. You know, at least they don't negotiate on salary basis. Why? Because of stereotypes. No, it is just not a matter of 1 or 2 days point. So what fairly say is, sadhyum se hi chala ja raha hai that women are not working. They are very, you know, lazy. They don't work. So they come and they work on their basis. Unke kaafi nakhre hote hain. So aap basically incorporate. Theek hai? कहीं भी अगर आप काम करते हैं तो फीमेल्स के ऊपर तो वैसे इतनी जी और स्टीरियोटाइप्स है. ओके, तो वो आपको प्रूव करते रहेंगे कि मैम आप इतना काम नहीं करते हो, राइट, मैम आप इतने फंक्शनल नहीं हो, और आपकी अचीवमेंट को कोई इतनी जल्दी से एक्सेप्ट नहीं करता और ना ही अप्रिशिएट करता है. ओके, और आपसे एक्सपेक्टेशन ही यही होती है कि आप बस काम करते हो, आपको कोई अप्रिसिएशन नहीं मिलती है. ये एक रियालिटी है. एंड ऑल दिस एग्जिस्टिंग रियालिटी, अब हमने एक लॉ ही बना दिया थिंकिंग के वुमेन को हेल्प होगा, बट व्हाट विल कंपनी डू, बिकॉज़ हियर दिस इज अ लॉ, सो दे विल स्टॉप हायरिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज वेरी चैलेंजिंग एंड इट विल डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू गिव अ लॉट ऑफ पॉइंट ऑन प्रमोशन. यू सी एंड इट्स इन रिपोर्ट, इट इज जस्ट नॉट आई एम सेइंग. आप किसी भी इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, नेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, कहीं का भी आप रिपोर्ट देख लें, यू विल सी दिस जेंडर डिस्पैरिटी. पे डिस्पैरिटी आपको दिखेगी, रिस्पेक्ट में डिस्पैरिटी आपको दिखेगा, हर तरीके से आपको डिस्क्रिमिनेशन दिखेगा. एंड आई बिलीव अगर ऐसा कुछ लॉ आता है तो डेफिनेटली वेदर वी एक्सेप्ट और नॉट, इट इज गोइंग टू ब्रिंग इम्पोर्टेंट एंड पोटेंशियल इफेक्ट ऑन हार्डिंग. ओके, सो आई थिंक जेंडर इक्वालिटी इतना नहीं रहेगा. नाउ वर्क प्लेस डायनामिक्स, डेफिनेटली वी कैन से दैट इट कैन लीड टू अ मोर इंक्लूसिव एंड सपोर्टिव वर्क एनवायरमेंट, बट देन क्रिटिसिज्म इज विदाउट प्रॉपर एजुकेशन एंड सेंसिटाइजेशन, सच पॉलिसीज कुड फॉस्टर रिसेंटमेंट अमंग एम्प्लॉइज हु परसीव देम एज अनफेयर और प्रेफरेंशियल ट्रीटमेंट. Now I can relate this with another example. So if you have ever traveled in Delhi buses, so we know that Delhi buses make females go free hand. Okay, so while females are traveling for, like, you know, free of cost, although it is not free of cost, we are paying in taxes. हम अच्छा खासा tax pay करते हैं government को, उसकी वजह से वो है कि हमको freebies देते हैं. एनीवे, सो कई बार मेल्स जो है वो सीट से नहीं उठते हैं, राइट, वो सीट से बिल्कुल नहीं उठते, आपको आपने तो टिकट भी नहीं लिया, आप क्यों उठ रहे हो. एंड दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस इन मेट्रो एयरपोर्ट. मेट्रो में जो सीट रिजर्व रहती है उसमें कोई मेल अपनी सीट नहीं देना चाहता है. अपनी सीट छोड़िए, अगर लेडीज के रिजर्व सीट पे बैठे रहते हैं उसमें भी उनको बड़ी आपत्ति होती है. And basically sometimes you will see a couple, so wife or girlfriend or boyfriend, if they are sitting, so they do not want to. और उस वक्त female ज़्यादा issue create कर दिया, आप मेरे husband को मत उठाइए जी, हम उठ जाते हैं. So this is the way stereotypes work, and this is not the way only, it's a problematic with husbands, it's a problematic with wives or girlfriends and all. तो ये एक ideology है, right? So If a wife would be like me, so मैं तो थप्पड़ ही ले रहा हूँ, जब सामने लड़की खड़ी है तमीज नहीं है, your mother has not taught you any upbringing, कोई values नहीं सिखाए,
बट ऐसा होता नहीं है जनरली, बट एनीवे सो जेंडर सेंसिटिवाइजेशन की बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी है राइट. और आप अभी हमारा देश आई बिलीव इतना इवॉल्व नहीं किया है और जहाँ हो भी गए हैं वहाँ पे आई डोंट नो हाउ इट वर्क्स ओके, बिकॉज देयर इज अ फार 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 गैप बिटवीन टीचिंग एंड प्रैक्टिसिंग ओके. सो दिस इज अनदर पॉइंट व्हिच वी कैन से हेल्थ एंड वेलबीइंग, वी कैन से व्हाट इज द क्रिटिसिज्म इट इज, सो देयर इज अ पोटेंशियल फॉर मिसयूज ऑफ मेंस्ट्रुएशन लीव व्हिच कुड अंडरमाइन इट्स legitimacy and effectiveness, right? So leading towards skepticism and reduced support for genuinely needed health accommodations, right? So this is how we can bring our debate. So I have discussed positive as well as negative aspect. So how we can conclude then our answer? So this is how I have given my answer on this, okay? Because you just need to frame. So from where you have started in introduction, you should try to end your answer in conclusion, summarizing all those important points. So I will write, in considering the menstruation leave debate, applying Calcutt Parsons' strict rule reveals the challenges of incorporating health policies within social and workplace frameworks. Acknowledging menstruation related health issues offers substantial advantages, but it is crucial to carefully assess the risk of perpetuating unfavorable stereotypes and consider the broader societal impact. Achieving a balance between offering empathy and support while also preventing stigmatization and discrimination is essential for establishing equitable and efficient policies. So this is how we all have to conclude our point. I hope you have got some benefit in your UPSC preparation with respect to this particular topic. Thank you.